know what I love about middle schoolers? You're so talkative. You always have something to say. The best part is that each of you probably has a different favorite thing to talk about. Some of you could go on and on about sports, while others of you could talk for hours about Shawn Mendes.
Even though we all have different things we like to talk about, I think the goal of many conversations is this. We want other people to experience what we love. Whether it's a movie we saw, a place we visited, or a sport we play, we love talking about the things we've personally experienced. And sometimes, talking about it makes others want to experience it too.
You don't have to know everything about something in order to talk about it. And I think the same is true when it comes to talking about God. In this series, we've been talking about what it means to know God. We've said things like creation and prayer help us to know God better. But have you ever thought that talking about God could help you know Him better too?
I think the more you talk about God, the more you'll know Him. And the more you'll know Him, the more you'll want to talk about Him. It's a cycle. But for many of us, the idea of talking about God or our faith can feel scary. And I think that's probably the reality for a couple reasons.
It could be you don't know what to say. Maybe you're afraid to talk about God because you don't really know how to bring up the topic or explain what you think. You're not exactly sure where to start or how to answer questions people might ask. You might even know some Christians who use big words that you don't understand. You talk about God, but you're not even sure what words you should use.
Or it could be that you're afraid it will be awkward. Nobody likes being stuck in an awkward moment, and that's why a lot of us don't talk about our faith. We're afraid it will make other people uncomfortable or offended. Or maybe you're curious about what it means to follow Jesus, but you're afraid that asking will make things weird.
Or it could be you're not sure you have the right information. You might not talk about your faith or God because you're not totally sure about it yourself. Even if you believe in God or think you understand Him, you're not positive you have it all figured out, and you don't want to look like you don't know what you're talking about.
Or it could be you don't know what you think. Maybe you have more questions than you do answers about God, and you're not sure it's okay to ask those questions. You're not even sure if you believe in God yourself, so why would you want to talk to others about Him? So often we treat God like an algebra equation. We think we have to know all the details in order to get the right answer. And until we have the right answer, we don't want to talk about it. So when it comes to talking about God, we decide to say nothing instead of something.
When you've experienced something awesome, you want other people to experience it too, right? If you've experienced even the smallest thing about God, then you know He's pretty great. And you should want other people to know that as well. And if you're not sure you've seen God at work in your own life, that's okay. A first step in your journey might be to talk with someone who has. Because sometimes, even just asking questions about God can help you know Him a little better. What if I told you that you don't need to be afraid of talking about God? In fact, even if you aren't sure what you think about God, I think one of the best ways to know God better is to talk about Him with other people.
Here's the truth. It's better to share who you know than what you know. In fact, that truth is what helped the church get started. The early church was started by a handful of guys who were passionate about one specific who, Jesus. They couldn't necessarily answer all the what's about Jesus, but they didn't let that stop them. They were so excited about who they'd experienced in Jesus, and they wanted others to be excited too. So they talked about Him a lot, even when they didn't know all the details.
In the Bible, the book of Acts gives us an amazing picture of what this looked like. Two of Jesus' friends and followers, Peter and John, ran around telling everyone about their favorite topic of conversation, Jesus. And while this was going on, a few religious leaders noticed something. When they saw the courage of Peter and John and realized that they were unschooled, ordinary men, they were astonished, and they took note that these men had been with Jesus.
It was obvious to the religious leaders that Peter and John were uneducated. Now, I know that's not usually a compliment, but in this case, I think it is. Peter and John didn't know as many intricate details or facts as other people might have. They probably wouldn't have won a debate about the details of Jesus' time on earth, but they did know the who of Jesus, and their experiences with the who is what astonished the religious leaders. The more Peter and John talked about Jesus, the more everyone around them not only realized that they knew what they were talking about, but also who they were talking about. In other words, they really knew God. Because they weren't afraid to talk about him, many of the people around them wanted to know him too. Peter and John didn't let the fear of being uneducated keep them from talking about Jesus, who they knew and experienced firsthand.
And the same can be true for you. You may not know all the answers, but you can know God more by talking about him. Talking about God would not only help others, it will help you as well, because talking about God helps us know God better. And the same is true when you hear other people talk about God.
It really is inspiring to hear someone else talk boldly about God. When you hear what God is doing in someone else's life, you begin to understand the character and heart of God more. Everyone in this room has questions to ask and stories to tell when it comes to God. Wouldn't you love to be as confident as Peter and John were, even though they didn't have all the answers? Well, you can be. All it takes is understanding two things that Peter and John knew.
The first is that you don't need to know everything to talk about something. Peter and John were obviously uneducated men. They weren't scholars or theologians, but they knew Jesus. They got to know God in the ways that we've been talking about in this series. They saw him in creation, and they actually spent time talking to him, and so can you. When you don't know the what, focus on the who. If you don't know how the world was made, just talk about who made it.
If you don't know how Jesus saves us, just talk about who saves us.
If you don't know why bad stuff happens, just talk about who never leaves us. For some of you, this is going to be difficult to do. Why? Well, because you're not so sure about all this God stuff. And that's okay. My encouragement to you would be to start talking about that. If you aren't sure that God made the world, talk to someone about it. If you're not sure that Jesus saved us, talk to someone about it. And if you're not sure that God won't leave us, talk to someone about it. Share your questions with your small group leader or a trusted friend, and simply start the conversation about God. Remember, you don't need to know everything to talk about something.
The other thing we can learn from Peter and John is that we can talk about God by sharing what he's done in our lives. What I love most about today's story is that when Peter and John talked about Jesus, people recognized immediately that they'd been with him. These guys may not have been able to answer everyone's questions, but they could talk about what they'd experienced. They were simply telling their stories. When you talk about Jesus, talk about what's happened in your own life. If you've seen him answer a prayer, share that.
If you've seen him change your attitude about someone, talk about that.
If you've ever seen him do something amazing in your life, tell it. Tell your stories. Talk about what you've experienced. After all, no one knows that story better than you. You're the person who lived it.
Peter and John kept talking about God, and thousands of people's lives were changed by it. They didn't have all the answers, but they did have their experiences. And the more they talked, the more stories they had to tell. In fact, they eventually both wrote all about it. And those stories have now been around for more than 2,000 years. They've helped millions upon millions of people know God better.
And it all started because they were willing to talk about him. Talking about God won't just help others know him better. Talking about God helps us know him better too. So as you go, ask yourself this question: what's one experience I've had with God that I could share with someone else?